Okay, it's Tuesday. I have a couple things I want to get out there real quick. First thing is, we had Zendi try the last dab Apollo. She's got a iron mouth or whatever. I don't even know how you say. It didn't really faze her. You'll see in a second. And then she also responded to our long form podcast conversation about past relationships and stuff. She had her own thoughts about dating and stuff that she wanted to chime in with. So we got that next. That'll be it for today.
Mike's vlog.
Let's try this hot sauce. Apollo Hot One's the last stab. But this one is the last, like the very, very last one?
Yes.
Oh, God. Chef Ramsey was like dying. I don't know if I can deal with that. He was dying.
Gotta shake it.
Shake it?
There you go.
That sounds so gross. Just throw the chip on this. Okay. Oh, God, I'm scared.
Gentle, baby.
How much should I do?
Like, a little more, yeah.
That's a rock.
There you go. That's for
me. I do a little more than that.
I do try a little bit more.
Do you want to do this again?
I'm being serious. That's how much I did.
Me and Mike did a little bit more than that, I think.
Yeah.
Mike, there you go. That's good. That's good amount.
Mike and I.
More than enough.
I'm so scared. The pressure is on. Oh, I'm scared. I got a seed. Did you guys get a seed?
Yeah, there was some chunks in there.
Okay, now let me have a backup chip just in case. Like, I need like a chaser chip, you know? God, I'm scared. I'm really scared. Okay, I've got a bit of a bite. That's it?
Okay, we're entering her in the hot pepper contest, all right?
It
was slow. Don't eat another chip, though. We all only had one chip.
No, we had more chips. I was
well, later, though.
Snarfing chips down.
So what I will say, it does, like, linger here. But, I mean, it's a little spicy here, but.
It's a little, goddammit.
I mean, I was full sink job.
This is about the time I couldn't hold it anymore.
Yeah, you started screaming.
I mean, it's just like my lips are kind of like burning a little bit, but.
Which is probably some of the salt with that too, you know?
We're literally signing her up for like the hot.
I mean, it's
like
a little hot, but it's not like my lips are kind of like tingling, but other than like, it's like my mom's hot sauce.
We're going to try it. Your mom is Pucker and Curry.
Yeah, I was going to say, because I've got those Apollo peppers just grow in the backyard.
I mean, probably.
Oh, my God. All right. Well.
Pretty good.
On to the next thing.
So, the boys talked about relationships in their previous podcast, and now I'm going to have the woman's perspective about it. So, just a few things I'd like to address, Ryan, Mike, and Brian. The puppy dogging. I get it to a degree. However, I think when you're in a situation that is like a new situation, like a wedding, or let's say a new bar, or you know, something like that, maybe not be on top of the guy, you know, but you need to stay close. Just to kind of get a feel for it. Now, I am definitely an introvert. I will sit in the corner alone, that's fine. And Ryan can go out and do his thing, that's fine. But if I'm in a situation where I don't know anyone, I expect him to be there with me at least and kind of introduce me or, you know, make it comfortable for me or like with family, but especially like a wedding, like something like that or a big party or something, you definitely need to have that person there. Now, I do also agree that it can't happen every single time. So if you're going to the same bar or whatever, and maybe it's like the third time you're there, you kind of get a feel for the place. Then, yeah, you don't want to be on top of it. Okay. Third is the Tinder profiles. Now, I made a Tinder a long, long, long time ago. Never actually, like, met anyone on there. I think online dating is really dumb. I think there's so many liars out there. I don't know. It's never been my thing. I don't think I'd ever do it. as a woman, you're just so scared. Like, this man could be some murderer that you don't even know about. Like, so for me, and again, I'm a very introverted person, but I could never. And if you have a picture of you with a fish, next, definitely not happening. Sorry, babe. But, no. Because you're happier holding a dead fish than you are with being with me. That's a problem. So I'm going to pass on that one. But, I mean, again, I don't really, can't really say much because I don't really have Tinder and or have ever really used it. But, they're gross. Then fourth is kind of like the lying versus not lying again. You have to tell the truth. You can't, like, maybe, you know, maybe not have to tell the truth about, like, something major, you know. Something that's, like, small, like, I don't know, where you live in case this person is, like, a murderer or something. I don't know. Like, I don't really know. Because it's just, don't say, like, you're some CEO of, like, Microsoft. No one's going to believe you. And then don't say, like, you're a cashier at, like, Hobby Lobby or something when you're, like, I don't know. You just got to be somewhat in, like, you got to be somewhat truthful. Again, I'm not, like, a shallow person. I'm not going to judge you because you are, like, a cashier at, like, Hobby Lobby. But if you're only working 10 hours and you're taking me to this Italian restaurant, I'm going to think you're, like, doing something else. Like, so don't, like, scare us away. Also, some women are just, I don't know. They're just kind of like, I'll take whatever I can get, which is fine, I guess. But not me, not most of us. There's still good ones out there. You just can't be looking for them in those places because that's where you're going to find them, especially Tinder. So, end rant. That was just my rebuttal, and you can take it or leave it, whatever, I don't care. But that's just my view on it, and I know the boys are dying right now because I made some good points, boys. So, yeah, that's all I got.
And then yo, I play my enemies like a game of chess where I rest. No stress if you don't smoke cess. Less.
Hey, Bri, what are we watching?
No.